In code, to create a camera position, you use a camera position builder. This builder takes the properties that you've just seen, such as the target, which is a latitude and longitude, the zoom that you want, how far you want to be zoomed into the map, the bearing of the camera, the direction that it's pointing in, and the tilt of the camera. When you've set all these properties and you build it, you will then get a camera position, and I've just called it CP here. Then, if you want to instantaneously update the map to show the location that the camera is pointing at with these values, you call map.moveCamera, and you pass it a camera update factory dot new camera position with that camera position that you've just defined. Like I said, this will instantaneously move the map to that location, but you may also want to animate the map to that position where you'll see a flyover type effect where you'll fly to the new location. And to do this, you'll use animate camera. And animate camera takes the same camera update factory dot new camera position with your camera position, but it also has a couple of extra parameters. One is the time in milliseconds that you want it to take to fly to the new location. Of course, you might want to zip over there really quickly, or you might want to slow pan up over the earth and down to the new location. You'd specify the time in milliseconds here. So if you wanted to take 5 seconds, you'd put 5,000 milliseconds in here. And the callback function gets called when the animation is complete. So if you want to execute some code once the animation is done, you could put it in that callback function. If you don't want to use a callback function, you can just put a null here. Let's take a look at an animated camera in action.